romantic.
What?
Max's old rust bucket.
I think she means Max and Deborah.
He's crazy about her. You can tell. Whoa, steady, girl.
She okay?
I think she hurt her leg.
Looks like her fetlock.
I better take a look.
Do you mind?
No, don't be silly.
What's wrong? Don't you like horses?
They just don't like me.
You just have to get to know them. Go on, pet him.
See? That wasn't so bad, was it?
Oh!
Ooh. Sorry about that. You know horses?
More than I ever thought I would.
Prance is fine. Ready to go?
Max, I can't go looking like this.
Ah, it's not so bad. You can cover the stain with your purse. Or not. Look, if you go all the way home to change, we'll miss our reservation. Oh, no, you can borrow some of Mum's clothes.
Did he just say... Oh, yeah, this is not going well.
Thanks, but maybe I'll just go home. We can do this another time.
Sure, okay. When's good for you?
I'll call you.
I'll call you. Poor Max. Even I know that's a kiss of death.
This is serious. Max needs major help in the romance department.
Romance novels?
If we're going to help Max, we need to do our research.
You don't need these. You did your research when you kissed Sky Ransom.
Do you and your mate relate? Why are we reading this romance stuff instead of horse magazines?
Horses mean Pine Hollow, which means Max. He needs our help.
Oh, okay. So what are we waiting for?
When do I get my surprise?
Soon, dear.
Well?
Ready when you are.
Great. Well, there she is.
Okay. Open your eyes. Don't you just love her?
Her name's Garnet, and she's all yours.
Well, what do you think?
Whose horse is that?
Mine. Isn't she beautiful?
She's okay. I guess.
Darling, why don't you take Garnet for a ride?
No. I don't want to ride her. I hate that stupid horse.
Well, you just said she was beautiful.
How can you say you hate Garnet? She's gorgeous, and she's a fantastic jumper.
She should be. We'll be paid for her.
Daddy, you said I could pick my own horse. And I didn't pick this one, so just return her or something.
You can't just return her like she's a pair of shoes.
Daddy, please, for me.
I'll have a word with the old owner. I can't promise anything, and if we're stuck with her, so are you.
Hi, Deborah. It's Max. I'm fine. How are you? Good. Look, about the other day...
Max!
Hang on just one second. What is it, Ashley?
I can't find Dime's saddle.
Did you check the tack room?
Yeah.
We'll check again. Sorry about that, Deb. And look, I'm really sorry about Prancer getting mud on you the other day.
The light's gone out in the tack room again.
Excuse me, they've just one more. So what do you want me to do about it?
Call an electrician?
I'll get to it. Later. I'm back. No, no, don't go. There won't be any more interruptions. I promise.
Yeah, I wouldn't bother. It's not the bulb. The wiring's shot.
Yeah, well, what did Max say?
Same as always. That he'll get around to it. But he never will. He's already got estimates, but it's too expensive.
Well, you don't need an electrician when you've got me. Pass me the screwdriver.
Look, I know my life is pretty much horses and riders at the moment, but I want to make time for other things. For you, just give me another chance. Great. Great, where would you like to go?
What the?
What? No, of course I'm listening. Dinner and a play. Sounds good to me. So, I'll pick you up at...
Hey.
Hello? Hello, Deborah. Hello?
I was just trying to fix the light.
I can't afford any more of your help. Thanks to you, the cost to fix the wiring just doubled.
Come on, Max. It had to be fixed sooner or later.
Well, I was hoping for later. This place is bankrupting me. And I still have to fix a broken window, the fence.
And the tractor.
What's wrong with the tractor?
I was going to tell you about that. See, there was this weird noise, and I was just trying to fix it.
Max, you're not going out with Deborah dressed like that, are you?
What do you mean?
You desperately need our help.
What's wrong with the way I'm dressed?
Everyone else gets a gorgeous horse, and I'm stuck with this mule. Don't you think that's unfair?
Huh? Oh, yeah, it totally sucks.
I mean, a mare? My parents knew I wanted a stallion.
Your life is so tough.
Tell me about it.
Need any help, Red?
No, thanks. Looks like you've already got your hands full.
I wonder how Max and Deborah are doing. If I fall asleep before they come back, you have to wake me up.
It's so romantic. Maybe they'll fall in love and get married, and then there'll be little Maxes and Deborahs running around Pine Hollow, riding on their little Shetland ponies.
You've been reading way too many of these romance magazines, Lise.
I have not. Give it back.
Prince or frog? Take your kissability quiz to find out.
Sorry. It's always acting up. It'll only take a few minutes to fix. We should have taken your car.
Don't worry. They'll hold our reservations.
I don't understand how you can't like horses.
I don't understand how you can get up at the crack of dawn to shovel horse manure.
Oh. What time do you city folk shovel your manure?
We try not to do it at all, actually.
They're holding hands.
Yeah, but they're talking about manure. Is that a good sign?
Shh. I can't hear what they're saying.
I like you, Max. The horses I could do without.
Me too, some days.
Really?
Yeah, look at this place. The pipes are rusting, the wiring's shot. I'm here 7 days a week. Do you know what I would give to sleep in just once?
She's complaining about Pine Hollow.
I thought Max loved everything about this place. And horses.
Max, I know it means a lot to you, but maybe you've outgrown it. It happens.
Yeah, I know. It's just hard. My father gave it to me.
Max, it's time to sell up. You agreed.
I hate to admit it, but you're right. Okay, I'll sell to the first buyer. Okay?
I don't believe it. Can't be true.
We all heard it.
Max is going to sell Pine Hollow.
Max can't sell Pine Hollow.
It's all because of Deborah. She's the one who hates horses.
Right. If we hadn't have been such great matchmakers, we never would have been in this mess.
That's right. We were such great matchmakers. So let's be great match breakers.
Hi, girls. Have you ever seen Max?
Oh, hi, Laurie.
Her name's Deborah.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It's just, I'm not very good with names, and it's kind of hard to remember you all.
Us all who?
Max's girlfriends.
Stevie?
Deborah dropped this off yesterday. It sure looks expensive.
I could buy a new tractor for what this would cost.
And who can take 2 weeks off?
2 weeks? I can't take 2 days around here.
That's too bad. Deborah's always talking about how much she wants to get away.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Travel's like her favorite thing. She doesn't like staying in one place for too long.
Mrs. Charlotte, Max has been looking all over for you.
He has? Why?
Don't know. I think it had something to do with Pandora.
What's wrong? I was just about to take her out for a hack.
You'd better talk to Max first.
It sounded really important. He's in his office.
Don't go in there.
Why not?
Because Max is sort of busy right now.
Oh.
Deborah, wait. Max has a surprise for you. Max is taking on a trail ride. Isn't that romantic?
Not sure romantic is the word I'd used. Look, where is Max?
He has to finish a couple of things first. So I'll help you with Patch.
You want me to get up on this animal?
What's wrong?
Nothing. It's just, from this angle, its nose looks a lot bigger.
You'll love him. You don't even have to steer. Patch knows the way.
Right. Okay. So I'll just, get on up. Not a problem. This is Max's idea of romance, huh?
You're not wearing that, are you?
You guys chose this suit.
I know. It's just, well, I guess Mrs. Reg and I were wrong. Deborah said that outfit made you look like a...
Like what?
A backcountry hick.
A backcountry hick?
That's why you've never met any of her friends. She didn't think they'd understand. Do you have time to change?
If this means so much to Max, then where is he?
Here, just swing your leg over the side and just hop off.
Oh, no! My shoes! My cute, one-of-a-kind, Sartori shoes! I had to have these custom made. They took 8 weeks and several little Italian men to make. And now, they're ruined!
I guess that's why Laurie always wears riding boots when she goes riding with Max.
Deborah!
Great surprise, Max. Look at me. I'm covered in mud. My shoes are ruined.
Well, I'm sorry if you're too good for this place. But if you can't stand a little dirt, then what are you doing in a stable?
Do you know that I'm afraid of horses? Then you get mad when I don't want to be around them.
Well, I guess I just don't get it, being a stupid farm boy. Obviously, I'm too dirty for someone as perfect as you.
Obviously, you're better off with one of your many horsey women.
Believe Veronica's parents. They bought her a horse without even asking her what she wanted.
This is an awesome horse. Check her out. She's got great legs. See her ears? She's totally listening to us. And you should see her move. It's like raw power. I'd kill for a horse like this.
Isn't he gorgeous?
Garnet's way prettier. Red says she's the best horse he's ever seen at Pine Hollow.
Not better than Cobalt.
He thinks you're crazy not to want Garnet. I told him I might buy her off you.
I didn't say I didn't want her.
Yes, you did.
I just said that I wanted my parents to check with me first. That's all. Garnet's not for sale.
What are you doing?
What?
Your class is waiting for you.
Oh. Right. Thanks, Mum. Hello? Sure. Any time after four? I'll be here. Thanks. Bye.
Not the call you were expecting. Max.
I didn't know you owned real shoes.
I'm not a total backcountry hick. I do have some small element of class.
Sure, whatever. You still on for fixing the fence in the west paddock?
I don't feel like it.
What's up with him? Sorry to bother you. Jake forgot to turn off the hose after he watered the horses this morning.
Okay.
No, see, there's a huge flood in three of the stalls.
I'm sure you can handle it.
Is he okay?
I've never seen him like this before.
He's miserable.
It's all our fault.
Did you see him in the lesson? He didn't even notice when Comanche got the wrong lead.
I know. It's like Max doesn't care about anything anymore.
We have to fix things.
Lisa's right. We're the ones who wreck things with Deborah. So we have to get them back together.
That means we lose Pine Hollow.
We'll always find another stable, but there's only one Max.
Please, Max, you have to come.
Why don't you get Stevie or Carole to go with you?
They're busy, and I need someone to go on the trail with me. Prance has been acting really spooky.
All right. I guess it's either that or get all this paperwork done. Let's go.
Mrs. Reg, are you busy?
No more than usual, Carol.
We need one of your famous picnics. Oh.
Saddle Club having its meeting in the field today, is it?
It's not for us. Well, it kind of is. We need to fix something.
And you need my gourmet sandwiches to do it. Say no more.
She's my horse. You're not taking her anywhere.
Well, you said you didn't want her.
I love this horse?
I just spent 3 hours convincing the old owner to take her back.
Daddy, if you don't let me have Garnet, I'll die. Look how much she loves me.
Okay, you can have the horse.
Where are we going? I thought this was supposed to be a quick interview for your school project.
It is. It's just, well, you know, get a better mark if you choose a creative background. Here we are.
What's this?
You probably want to be left alone.
No!
Would someone like to tell me what's going on?
Look, I should go.
No, wait. You can't. It's all our fault. Max doesn't really have lots of girlfriends. We made that up. And Deborah never called you a backcountry hick.
And Deborah never dropped off those travel brochures.
We're really sorry, but we didn't want you to sell Pine Hollow.
What? Who told you that?
We heard you. You said you were going to sell it to the first buyer who came along.
I'd never sell Pine Hollow.
We were talking about his truck. It's a death trap.
So you never said?
I'd die before I left this place.
That'll teach you to eavesdrop.
Oops.
Oops.
We should be going now.
See you back at the stables.
Hold it. You think you can wreck a man's life and get away with it.
We're really, really sorry.
I don't think that's good enough. You deserve to be punished.
Definitely. None of my mother's gourmet sandwiches for you.
That's cruel.
Oh, yes. Bye-bye.
Are we good or what?
If we hadn't have broken them up in the first place,
then they wouldn't have been as happy to get back together.
Another excellent plan from the Saddle Club.
Come on, Lisa. You have to tack up prance now. You're gonna be late for the lesson.
I know. I just have to finish this chapter.
What's under that rock?
A guide to geology.
Please don't tell me you're reading that for fun.
I have a big test on Friday.
What's more important, rocks or horses?
And I also have a report due on Thursday, a ballet recital on Saturday, and a clarinet lesson tomorrow night.
And a writing lesson in 5 minutes. I tacked up prancer for you. Max is already out there, so you guys better hurry up.
Thanks, Red. I owe you one.
Don't burn yourself out, okay? Prance is still a hot horse, and you need to save your energy for the riding ring. See? Even the barn gods agree.
Hey, Stevie! Look!
Shh!
I'm Liam, Red O'Malley's cousin.
What were you doing in the hayloft?
Just getting a better look at the stables. You can see everything from up there.
Especially with those on.
So, you guys must like horses, huh?
No, we just hang out here for the hay.
Does Max know you're here?
Yeah. I mean, we haven't met or anything, but I've spoken to him about buying one of his horses.
Which one?
Oh, whatever's for sale. My parents own a huge ranch with lots of horses, really big ones. And so I kind of grew out of my old stallion.
Too bad. I don't think Max has any stallions for sale.
Well, we've got to go. We're late for a lesson.
Nice meeting you, Liam. He was kind of weird, but he seemed okay.
I don't trust him.
Why not?
I don't know. I mean, he shows up out of nowhere, says he wants to buy a horse.
I guess it is kind of weird how he was hanging out in the hayloft. Right, Lisa? Hello, Earth to Lisa.
What?
What's with you?
Nothing. I've just got a lot on my mind right now. That's all. Come on, Max will freak if we're all late.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, where?
Fred, I was just looking for you.
What are you doing here?
I came to see you. This place is so cool. It looks just how you described it on your emails.
Where's Aunt Karen and Uncle Colin?
At home.
They let you come by yourself? What's up?
Nothing. You know, it's like at Richmond Crossing. It's totally dead. I mean, there's nothing to do.
Yeah.
And I got straight A's on my report card, so my parents said I could hang out with you for a couple of days.
Cool. Well, you better give him a call. Let them know you got here okay, so you're not freaking out.
Phone?
This is the boss's office. It's off limits. Ah, don't touch that. That's Max's prized possession.
Ugly. Hi, Mum. It's me. Yeah, I'm in Willow Creek. The bus ride was fine, yeah. Red says hello. Yeah, he's great. Yeah, it's great to see him again. Yeah, yeah, a bit thin. Must be all...
What's wrong?
Nothing. Just got a stitch.
You seem kind of tired in the lesson. Are you okay?
I'm fine.
You should go lie down in the lounge. I'll finish Prancer for you.
Are you kidding? I don't have time to lie down. But thanks anyway.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's only a stitch. It'll be gone in a second. And so will I. I have to be home to babysit Melanie.
Slow down. You're making me tired.
Is this your horse?
I wish. Comanche's a school horse, but I ride him all the time.
I used to have a horse just like this, but we had to sell him when we moved to China. I really miss him.
What was his name?
Bob.
Really?
Oh, yes, so how many hands was your horse exactly?
Horses don't have hands, Phil. They're called hooves.
That's not what I meant.
He knows what you meant. He was just joking. Some people do that. It's called having fun. Well, I've got to run. Got to turn Comanche out.
Liam and I can do that for you, Stevie. It's no problem, right?
Sure, no problem.
All right, well, knock yourselves out.
Go ahead. Turn Comanche out.
All right, then I'll turn him out. Come on.
So you've done this before, right? With all those horses you own?
Yeah, all the time.
Do you always turn out horses like that?
Yeah, why?
You might want to untack him first.
Oh, right, I was just gonna do that.
Phil's acting really weird. What did he do? He was actually nice to me. Where's Lisa? She's left already for homework.
clarinet, babysitting, and about a million other things.
You know your horse expert, Liam?
What about him?
He was gonna turn out Comanche without untacking him first.
Yeah, right.
Seriously, I had to help him. He didn't even know how to undo a bridle.
Wait a sec. You're the one who volunteered to help me, right?
Sure.
So maybe he just didn't feel like turning Comanche out. You kind of put him on the spot.
I'm telling you, this guy doesn't know the first thing about horses. He's a liar.
Why are you picking on him?
Yeah, leave him alone. Fine. You don't believe me? I'll prove it.
Going on? Who are you?
Well, that's Liam, my cousin. I told you, Ben.
It was an accident. Phil didn't mean to break your trophy.
What? Me? It was him.
Just say you're sorry, Phil.
He's lying just like he lied to the girls. He said he was here to buy a horse.
Did you break this, Liam?
No, I wasn't even in here. I just came running in when I heard the crash.
Phil?
I saw him break it.
Okay, I've heard enough. Neither of you should have been in here.
But...
out. Out.
Liam would never break something and try to hide it.
And Phil would?
I don't know Phil very well, but I know my cousin.
Well, maybe you should just keep a closer eye on him.
What's that supposed to mean?
Look, Red, someone's lying. And I don't appreciate anyone in my office, okay?
He's my cousin, and if he said he didn't do it, he didn't do it.
Are you sure you don't want to wait? And I'll come with you.
I have to study right after this.
Why don't you take a break, and I'll exercise Prancer for you.
Thanks, but this is the only fun thing I get to do today. Come on, Prancer. Maybe we better head home.
Pine Hollow. Yes, he is. One moment. Red, for you.
Hello. I'm Karen. What? Calm down. Liam's here with me. He got here yesterday. He called you.
I can't believe your parents sent you to a riding camp in Hawaii.
Just for a month. Then we moved to Bermuda.
I thought you said you lived in China.
I did. The year after we lived in Bermuda. We travel around all the time.
I know what it's like. My dad's in the military. Don't you hate it when you have to leave all your friends and then you're like the new kid all the time?
I guess. I don't really have any good friends, so it doesn't really matter.
Really? I'd die if my dad took me away from Stevie and Lisa. And Pine Hollow.
Red emails me all the time. He tells me all about this place. It makes me feel a part of it all. I guess that's why I wanted to come here.
And buy the horse?
And to buy the horse, yeah.
Here's a picture. I can't believe you would sink that low.
You broke Max's trophy and tried to pin it on me.
You've been bad-mouthing the guy ever since he got here. And then conveniently, it just happened to see him break Max's favorite trophy.
Are you saying I set the whole thing up?
You said it, not me. It's ready.
And I don't just let anybody ride a horse along the Great Wall of China.
Wow. You did that?
No, you didn't.
Red, I was just,
I think the word you're looking for is lying.
See, I told you.
What's going on?
Simple. Liam hasn't said a word of truth since he got here. Haven't you, Liam?
Well, truth is a tricky thing.
I'll make it easy for you. Liam's never owned any china, let alone been there. And his parents have been worried sick ever since they found out he ran away.
You ran away? He said he was shopping for a horse.
That would be crazy since he lives in a condo. I found these in Max's office. Thought you told me you didn't go in there.
Fred, it was an accident.
You broke the trophy. You blamed it on Phil. I trusted you. I stood up for you. Sorry, Phil. Your parents are on the way to get you. Pack your bags. You're in a lot of trouble, Liam.
You have to take me back to Pine Hollow. Come on. Oh, girl, not so fast.
I don't figure I have to apologize, Phil.
But you didn't believe me when I told you about Liam.
I don't believe you when you tell me anything.
Why?
I don't know.
I find that very depressing, Stevie.
Back to the stables. I'll try and put you on your horse.
Oh, I can't move. You have to go get help, Liam.
I want to help, but I'm in a lot of trouble. I can't go back there.
Please, Liam, please.
Oh, someone here in a flash.
Fred, Mum and I are just off the Willow Creek, okay? Something wrong?
Are you kidding? Everything's perfect. Back to normal. Just the way it should be.
Red, you're supposed to do that outside.
Yeah, right. Sorry. I just got a lot on my mind.
Well, for the sake of my lungs, why don't you call it a day? I'm sure you'd like to spend some time with Liam.
No, I don't. And even if I did, I can't. He's gone.
He's gone? Where?
Probably hiding from me till his parents get here. You were so right about him. He did break the trophy, and he didn't even have the guts to take responsibility. He's a pathological liar.
Well, I'm sorry to hear it.
He's been conning everyone from the moment he got here. He looked right into my eyes and lied to me.
How old is he again?
14.
Yeah. Try and remember what you were like at 14, before you dismiss him altogether. And, Red, remember too that he's still your cousin, okay?
Bill! Come quick, it's an emergency.
Wait, let me guess. Your parents are sending you to Russia.
What? No, really, it's Lisa.
No, I got it. Your parents are Russian spies sent here on a secret mission.
Red!
Don't want to hear it, Liam.
Lisa!
Isn't anyone coming to help?
Don't worry. Come on.
Can't carry me.
I've got to get you on that horse. Come on.
Oh, Prancer.
Wow. Come on.
Lying the whole time. I'm just glad he's gone.
I guess, but I feel kind of sorry for him. I don't think he has any friends.
Carole! Stevie! Help!
Max!
Lisa!
Anybody, help!
Oh, Lisa, what's wrong?
My stomach.
Call an ambulance, quick!
She's all right.
What was wrong?
It was her appendix.
That's pretty serious, isn't it?
Yes. They operated just in time. We were lucky she got to hospital when she did.
I can't believe everyone was ignoring Liam.
The one time he was telling the truth.
He's outside. I think he wants to see you girls before he leaves. If you want to.
Of course we want to see him.
Liam, come in. Mrs. Reg says Lisa's gonna be okay.
You totally saved her.
Tell her goodbye from me.
Will you come back and visit us, Liam?
Well, I didn't think you'd want me to.
You saved our best friend. You're welcome anytime.
Mrs. Reg says she's having a fall.
Yeah.
Mum and Dad are waiting for me outside.
Okay.
Red, I'm really sorry.
About lying or being caught?
About lying, especially to you. You're the best, Red. Your emails are so cool. Life is so excellent at Pine Hollow. I guess I wanted to be part of it all.
Why lie?
I didn't think they'd be interested in me.
You didn't even give them a chance. You lied to them before they even knew your name. Liam, it takes a long time to fit in and to make friends.
I wanted them to like me.
Trust me. People will like the real Liam a lot better than the one you made up.
So, does this mean you're not angry at me anymore?
You still have to work at getting my trust back.
I will, and I'll start taking responsibility for my screw-ups.
You already showed you can be responsible when you came back here to help Lisa.
So, can I stay with you then?
No.
Oh.
But you can visit. Just next time, tell someone you're coming first. Deal?
Deal. See ya.
Yeah, see ya.
Just saw Liam leaving with his parents. He'll probably be grounded for the rest of his life.
Mrs. Reg told them how he saved Lisa. He'll probably be coming back for a visit during the holidays.
We're really sorry we didn't believe you.
We?
What?
You're sorry?
For not believing you, yeah, sorry.
Wait, did I hear right? Stevie Lake just admitted she was wrong?
Can't be. I didn't say I was wrong. I said I was sorry. It's completely different.
Here we are with Dr. Judy at the impending birth of Delilah and Cobalt's baby. So tell me, Dr. Judy, what's the scoop?
Delilah's looking good. She could go into labor any day now.
How will we know when that happens?
Delilah will let us know. Contractions hurt.
You heard it here first, folks. Contractions hurt. Full expected soon. This is Stevie Lake signing off for full watch.
And cut.
Wait, don't stop filming. Dr. Judy hasn't finished the exam yet.
I know, but I have to save some film for the actual birth. It could happen any minute now.
Well, Lisa and I hope it's not today. I'm going out with the girls.
And I've got my audition for a school play.
I shouldn't worry. The croup isn't relaxed, so it probably won't happen for a couple of days yet.
But what if it does?
Mares deliver healthy foals all the time. Usually it happens so fast, the vet doesn't even get there.
I'd die if we missed it. We could ask Max if we can sleep over.
And mount a foal watch.
You promise to come while Tina's here, and I'll give you all the apples you can eat.
Now, is Tina that lovely red-headed girl whose parents moved a few years ago?
Yeah, we were like twins, both brilliant, charming, horse-crazy, and...
And humble. Don't forget humble.
Who's that?
Beats me. I hope she's not planning on riding in that get-up.
Stevie! I can't believe it! Oh, you look exactly the same!
Oh, yeah, you too, Tina. Oh.
Clothes, the hair.
That's not all.
Cool. Doesn't it rub when you wear jeans?
Not if you wear hip huggers.
Tina? Is that you?
In the flesh.
Oh, you look so good.
Thanks.
You used to look like, well, Stevie. See, some things never change.
Talk to me about the weather, Mr. Worthing. Whenever people talk to me about the weather, I always feel quite certain that they mean something else. And that makes me so nervous.
Don't mumble. You've got to speak from your dire...
Dire what?
Here in your stomach. The director of my movie said it helps you speak louder.
It was Skye Ransom's movie. You only had one line.
Only bad actors count their lines. Besides, it's one line more than you had.
Can we just rehearse, please?
Charming day it has been, Miss Fairfax.
Pray don't talk to me about the weather, Mr. Worthing.
Better than talking about your acting. You're not going for the part of Gwendolyn. Shouldn't you try for something a bit more realistic, like ticket seller?
Do you think you'll get the lead?
Let's see. Gwendolyn is a tall, blonde, beautiful heiress. Who else? Oh, and Lisa. Save some tickets for my parents. They love to see me in the spotlight.
Okay, Melanie, from the top.
Hi. Guess what? Lisa thinks she's got a chance at the role of Gwendolyn. Isn't that hilarious?
About the play.
I know. We'd better start rehearsing.
Actually, I'm gonna pass. I was thinking about hanging out with Tina.
Oh. Well, I guess I could do that too.
No, I wouldn't want you to miss your audition. Tina and I'll catch up with you later.
That's the withers. It's the knobby bit at the base of the neck.
Right.
The foal is on its back. It has to do a 180-degree swivel when labour begins.
Oh, that's a lot of swivelling.
Yes, it is.
It moved. It's not about to, swivel yet, is it?
Not yet.
Poor thing. Must feel like you've got an elephant in there.
Well, full term, a foal is pretty big, but then that's nature.
Well, that's easy for you to say. She's the one who has to give birth to it.
Hi, Max, Deborah. This is Tina.
Oh, yes, I remember you, Tina. I think. You have grown up.
Oh, thanks.
Now, I've told Carole it's okay with me if you want to stay the night. But you have to check it with your folks, okay?
Thanks, Max.
Did you relax? She likes you.
Sure?
I never realised what a mega babe Max was. Max? He's so old. Hey! My dad brought over the sleeping bags. This is gonna be so cool.
You're gonna sleep in the loft?
Sure. We didn't want to make Delilah nervous by crowding her in her stall.
Pretty exciting weekend.
Are you kidding? What's more exciting than seeing a foal being born? It's more like a sleepover, really. You'll see, it'll be fun.
Whatever. Wow, Stevie, you haven't changed. This room looks like it did a year ago.
I'm not exactly a neat freak.
You can say that again. I think I left this shoe here last year.
Wow! What do you think? Is it me?
You can borrow it if you want.
Thanks. So what do you want to do? We could go for a hack. You want to see Comanche jump?
We're getting really good.
Actually, I told Christy to come over.
Christy? But we hate her.
I don't know. She seems kind of cool now. You don't mind, do you?
What about Fall Watch? Oh, I told Carole we'd be there.
We can still go. Later.
Blue eyes you have, Ernest. They are quite, quite blue. Hello, Stevie. Hey, Stevie. What about indigo for a boy and sapphire for a girl?
What?
Oh, names to the foal. Are you taking a shower?
I forgot how much horses smell.
Stevie, are you listening? Oh, what? Yeah, it sounds great. Look, Tina and I have planned, but we'll be at the stables as soon as we can. Are you okay? You sound different. Yeah, I'm fine. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
What wonderful eyes you have. No. What wonderfully blue eyes you have, Ernest. They are quite, quite...
And remember the time Patch took off across the field with you on him?
Remember? My butt's still sore.
My stomach's still sore from laughing. And remember the time...
Christy!
Hi.
Cool earring. I love your shoes. Mm-hmm.
Remember Brad from the football team?
The Robo Bay.
He totally wants to see you again. He's at the mall.
No way. I have to change. What am I gonna wear?
You better hurry. I don't know how long he's gonna be there.
Oh,
you're leaving now? But I told Carole we'd be at the stables.
That's right, Foal Watch. That's okay, you go ahead. Christy and I can hang out.
No, wait, I'm coming. I just have to do something first.
This is Cobalt, the father. He'd want to be here for the birth.
Hello. Carole, Stevie wants to talk to you.
Finally, where is she? Where are you? You said you were going to be here by now. Something's come up.
What's more important than the foal?
Carole, Tina's only in town for today. I'll help out with Foal Watch later.
Besides, who knows when Delilah will foal? It could be days.
You know what Dr. Judy said.
Look,
It's no big deal, right?
Fine. If you don't think it's a big deal, don't bother coming at all.
Bye.
Let's go.
Stevie's gonna miss the whole thing. She doesn't even care.
Dr. Judy said Delilah probably won't fall for days.
Not you too.
I'm not copping out. It's just, I've got my audition.
So?
It's really important to me. And I can't concentrate on my lines here. There's too much going on. I really, really want this part, Carol. I'd die if Veronica got it. It's only for tonight. I'll do the sleepover tomorrow. I promise.
Fine.
Great. I knew you'd understand.
I understand, all right. They don't care about Delilah or the new foal or me.
It moved! I felt it move!
This is for actors. I think they're interviewing ushers down the hall.
I've got as much chance of getting this part as you, Veronica. Or Cindy.
Dream on, Lisa.
Sorry, John. We're going to be about 15 minutes late. Oh, thank you. We're looking forward to it.
You going out for dinner?
Yeah. It's a long drive, but it's our favourite restaurant. Max took me there on our first date.
That's really romantic.
Hey, where's the rest of the foal watch team?
Guess they had more exciting things to do than watch a foal being born.
Well, they're your best friends. They'll show up.
Not tonight.
Well, if it helps, Delilah doesn't look like she's going to fall anytime soon.
We've got to go.
Right.
You gonna be okay?
Yeah. You guys have a great time.
And if anything happens, you can contact us on Deb's cell phone. Number's on the board, okay?
Okay.
Brad is a dream, even better than I remembered.
He's up for this year's football medal.
He's so mature. Not like some of the guys in my grade.
Yeah, mine too.
Oh, we have to decide what we're going to wear tonight.
Why don't we go to the stables first?
The only reason to go to the stables is to see Red. And Red's had the day off.
Is there anything in the fridge? I'm starving.
Sure, help yourselves. Supposed to last you all night. The foal is turning. Deborah Hale.
Lisa.
Hello? No way. I'll try, but I'm supposed to do my audition. Hello? Carole? Delilah's gonna have a baby.
Good, you better go, right now.
Don't you wanna come? It is Cobalt's fault.
Nice try. You want me to leave so they have to give you the part. I'll see it tomorrow when it's clean.
Thanks, Cindy. We're ready for you now, Lisa.
I'm sorry. I have to go.
Lisa?
Veronica.
I'd die if Brad saw us like
this.
Oh, no,
it's cracking. I can't smile.
There. Finished.
Are you sure you don't want me to put this face pack on you?
Totally sure. I think it's time we join Carole.
She'll let us know if anything happens.
Don't you want to go?
Look, Stevie, I'm not so into horses as I used to be. I stopped riding when we moved to the city.
But you love horses.
I used to. It's no big deal. Horses are a phase most kids go through, but there's more to life than mucking out stalls. You'll see. You grow out of it too.
Actually, I think I have to go.
Why? What's wrong?
There's something I've got to do.
Like what?
You wouldn't understand. It's too immature for you.
Stevie!
Delilah's water broke 10 minutes ago. So far, so good. Now we're just waiting for the baby.
Carole, is it starting?
Shh, can you be any louder?
Sorry, what's happening?
Don't worry about it. I know you have more important things to do.
Did I miss anything? Help Delilah.
Shh. Oh, she's in labor right now.
What do we do?
Nothing.
Don't be like that, Carole. We're here now.
Yeah, now. Where were you when she was waxing up and when her tail had to be wrapped and when her water broke? I thought we were gonna do this together.
We are.
I was the one who stayed here while you guys just left.
Get over it. You're acting like we took off on you or something.
You did.
That's not true. Dr. Judy said the foal would be
We have to call Dr. Judy.
Battery's dead.
I'm not going to get there for about an hour. I won't be in time to help.
What if something goes wrong?
Calm down. Mares deliver healthy foals all the time. It'll be so fast, you'll be lucky if you don't miss it.
What's she doing now?
What is she doing now?
She's breathing really hard and looks scared.
She's breathing hard and looks scared.
Did you hear that?
Yes. She'll be fine. Just let her do the work. What can you see?
Carole, what can you see?
Can you see the foal's feet?
Nothing.
She can't see anything.
Tell her to look carefully.
Hold on. I think I can see something. Yes!
Stevie, are you there?
Carole, the video!
The best part.
No, 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 I can't. I've got a weak stomach.
Look, you've got to get over this phobia of yours.
Oh, I can't.
And the only way to do it is to face your fears.
Oh.
There's an
that something? What do you think?
It's cute. If only it'd stay that size forever.
See you later, Tina. Bye, Christy.
Looks like Tina's been out shopping again.
Hi, guys. What is it?
A fall?
I mean, boy or girl?
Boy.
Here, it's a present for the baby. Lisa, what's its name?
Oh, yeah, we haven't decided. Is he an indigo?
I don't know. What do you think?
A horse? Yeah, he'd look kind of stupid with a teddy bear, wouldn't he?
Thanks.
I'll call next time I'm in town.
You know where to find me.
You're not gonna give up on this horse thing, are you?
No way.
Hi.
Hi.
Tina's leaving today.
Oh. Did you get the part?
No. They gave it to Cindy Browning. Her father just happens to be on the board. It sickens me the way people abuse their positions like that.
Did Lisa totally suck?
She would have, but she left. She wanted to see the foal.
What's with everyone? It's just a baby horse. It's not going anywhere.
That's what I said.
Do you want to hang out after the lesson?
Sure.
Come on, Stevie. We have to give him a name.
Carole should choose.
You're the one who stuck it out with Delilah.
You know, I've been trying to think of a name that has something to do with cobalt, like sapphire or indigo. But what about something to do with Delilah? I was thinking maybe Samson? You know, like Samson and Delilah.
That's perfect.
Welcome to Pine Hollow, Samson.
The way she flirts with him.
I know, it's pathetic.
What barbecue?
Phil's family's throwing a big party this weekend. Very upscale.
Anyone who's anyone is invited.
Calm down. It's his parents' party. Phil probably had nothing to do with it.
Yeah, right. How come he totally ignored me?
He didn't even see you.
Got it! It's okay. Easy, girl. Easy.
Veronica left her out in the riding ring.
Big surprise.
She left Garnet out there all by herself? She didn't even untack her?
Remember what she did to Cobalt? She's gonna do the same thing to Garnet.
Oh, no, she's not. There's no way Veronica's gonna get away with this.
you're putting on nail polish.
Yeah, but this stuff stinks. Smell.
Yuck. Are you sure that's good for him?
Yes.
What are you girls doing?
Just doing Dime's feet.
I appreciate your help, girls, but Ashley, you know you shouldn't be working around the horses without talking to me or one of the stable hands.
I know, but...
It's for your own safety.
But we were just trying to help with the horses.
Well, there are plenty of safer jobs around the stables that you and Melanie can do all by yourselves. Come along.
Safer. Great.
The paper's probably going to cover Phil's party for the society page.
What are you going to wear?
I don't know. My mum's picking me up to go shopping.
Were you planning on untacking Garnet, or were you just going to leave her standing out there all day?
It's not my problem. Ask the stable hands. It's their job. We found her running loose in the riding ring.
She could have been hurt.
Christy, the Spazzle Club is mad at me.
Gee, I wonder if it's because you're invited to Phil's party and they're not.
He's so cute. Can I brush him?
Not right now, Melanie.
Why not? What's wrong? Where's Delilah?
Samson hasn't been eating properly.
What do you mean?
Mastitis. It hurts Delilah when Samson feeds, so she kicks him away.
She's a bad mum.
No, she's sick. She can't help it. The vet put Delilah on antibiotics and she'll be better soon.
But what about poor Samson?
He won't take any food from us. We've tried everything. Dr. Judy's going to feed him through a tube.
How would you feed a foal with a tube?
We have to put it down his throat. It doesn't hurt him.
That's awful. You're mean.
He's got to eat, Melanie. He'll be fine. Don't worry.
You can't just keep ignoring the horse like that or it'll go wild.
But she never spent any time with Cobalt either. And he was perfect.
The only reason Cobalt was so great was because Carole rode him all the time.
I guess I could ride her.
No! You can't keep on saving Veronica's butt. So what if her horse goes wild? It's her own fault.
I don't care about Veronica. I care about Garnet.
Hey, guys. You busy? Red's got his hands full with Samson, and I promised to deliver some portable horse enclosures today. I could really use a few extra hands. Anyone up to helping me?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sure.
Good. One spirited mare.
Well, it's my own fault. I haven't had time to ride her all year. I think she's given up on me.
Mm.
Oh, and thanks for helping me out with those enclosures, Max. I was at wit's end.
Ah, it's no problem. I did have some help. Wow. Stevie, Carole, Lisa, this is Dee Marston.
Hi, girls.
Marston? You mean you're...
Yeah.
Mom! Hi, Phil.
Come on.
What are you doing here? I mean, you're helping Max, I can see that. How long are you staying? You're leaving soon, right?
Don't try to climb over. You might hurt Samson.
Open the door.
Forget it.
Looks like you've got an extra foal on your hands today.
Hey! Ooh. Mrs. Reg?
You're doing just fine, Reg.
No one's sticking any tubes down Samson's throat.
It's not going to hurt him.
Go away. I'm taking care of him.
Be careful in there. He's only a baby.
Duh. See what I mean? He so doesn't want me here. He practically asked us to leave.
He's just acting weird because he's nervous around you.
Yeah, right.
He totally likes his Stevie. Of all the jobs we could have done for Max,
We had to pick the one that ended up at Phil's house.
Did you see her? She's perfect.
Nomad?
Yeah. Paint a blaze on her forehead. Groom her properly, brush out her mane, and what have you got?
A dead ringer for Garnet.
Except she's not a trained horse.
Okay, I bought four choices. There's this top with these pants. They're totally hot in New York right now.
They're okay, but I thought this party was formal.
It is. We're talking big social event.
Ew, that's so my mother dressed me.
What about this? Do you think it's too ordinary?
That could be okay. Depends. Are you wearing your hair up or down?
You're right. I have to figure that out too. How am I ever going to be ready by Saturday?
Here you go. Nice warm cow's milk. It's yummy. Come on. Samson, you'll love it. Hey, that's okay. I'll make you some more.
That's it. I'm opening this door.
It's okay, Red. Just leave her.
But she doesn't understand.
Let her come to it. Otherwise, she's going to get more upset.
So, we put Nomad in Garnet's stall, tack her up, and when Veronica comes to do her dressage lesson, she'll learn just how hard it is to do flying changes on a horse that won't listen to her.
But won't she notice that it's not her horse?
Hey, this is Veronica we're talking about. She's gonna be thinking about what she's wearing, not what she's riding.
You're right. By the time she figures it out, she'll already be making a fool of herself in the dressage ring.
And maybe, when she rides an out-of-control horse like Nomad, she'll realize how lucky she is to have Garnet.
It's perfect! But aren't we forgetting one huge thing?
What?
How are we going to get Nomad?
Hey, Phil!
No way.
We need to borrow your horse. Come on, Samson, please. You'll love it. Just one little sip.
Melanie, can you let us in, please? Dr. Judy's here to see Samson. It's okay. Delilah's had a shot and she'll be fine in a day or two. But right now, Samson needs to be fed.
You can help me feed him if you like.
No way!
It won't hurt him one bit, I promise.
No.
Come on, Melanie. Enough is enough.
I just want to teach Veronica a lesson, so she'll start looking after Garnet.
Okay, count me in.
Great. So we'll see you tomorrow morning for Operation Flying Change.
Sorry to break up the reunion, guys, but we should get back.
Yeah, thanks for all your help, girls. It was really nice to finally put some faces to the names. Phil talks about you all the time. So I hope we'll see you all this weekend.
No! I mean... It's just a family thing. They'd be bored.
Well, Phil, it's okay. We're having a family barbecue Saturday afternoon and you'd all be more than welcome.
Mum, I told you, they don't want to come.
Phil, will you stop it? You're being rude.
It's okay, Mrs. Marsden. We're all busy on Saturday anyway.
If Phil's in, then I'm out.
Come on, Stevie. He was embarrassed.
He wanted to rub it in that he invited Veronica to his party and not us.
If he really liked Veronica,
Why would he help us trick her?
I don't know. He must be planning to humiliate me again somehow.
Forget about Phil. Think about teaching Veronica a lesson.
What's more important, Garnet or Phil's stupid party?
Come on, Stevie, we really need you. We can't pull off a plan like this without you. Okay, I'll do it. But I'm not talking to Phil ever, got it?
I'll call him.
Phil! Oh, are you hiding out here? Girl just phoned.
Who?
Lisa from Pine Hollow.
Oh.
Were you hoping it was someone else?
No.
Actually, I'm surprised any of those girls are calling you after the way you acted. Hey. I can't believe how rude you were.
I told you I didn't want them to come.
But isn't Stevie the girl that you couldn't stop talking about?
No.
Well, I think that you hurt her feelings.
She doesn't care.
Well, I think that she does. I saw her looking at you.
She does not.
Look, why don't you just invite her on Saturday? I bet she says yes, and she might even help...
I'm not inviting anyone. She's busy on Saturday anyway.
The secret. It's got to be in one of these things.
Secret? What secret?
Defeating the foal. I just don't want them to put a tube down his throat.
Oh, you know we wouldn't do anything to hurt Samson.
But he's only a baby.
Okay. Right.
We have to hide it before Veronica gets here.
Shouldn't the creep be here with Nomad by now? Looks like your creep's right on time.
Looking for something, Stevie?
Nope. I got it. Thanks.
I don't believe it. That cupboard looks like a bomb hit it. We'll have to get that cleaned up one of these days.
Oh, yeah. Messy. See you later.
This stuff's gross. Do you think it'll stay on long enough?
I hope so. If it comes off, we're dead.
Like the new jacket?
What's wrong with your neck?
He's right over there.
Who?
What's he doing here? He doesn't have a lesson today.
Isn't it obvious? He's come to watch your private lesson.
Of course.
Hi, Phil.
Hi.
It was nice of you to come watch. I mean, it's just another lesson, but...
Oh, yeah. I just wanted to see how you're doing with Garnet.
She's an absolute dream. It's like we were made for each other.
Hello? My horse better be tacked up. My lesson starts in 5 minutes.
Hurry!
Get out of my way. You're going to make me late for my private lesson. Something's wrong. Stable hands did their job for once. It's about time people started paying attention around here. Come on, Garnet. Walk on.
She didn't even notice. we probably could have switched Samson and Garnet, and Veronica wouldn't even know the difference.
Come on, I don't want to miss a single second of this lesson.
Hi, Samson. Sorry I left yesterday, but I had to figure out something. Are you hungry?
Do you think she'll try a half pass?
I hope she tries a flying change.
This should be good. I'm just glad I got to help. I can't wait to see.
Oh, I get it. So I'm good enough to talk to at Pine Hollow, but not good enough to come to your party. And Veronica is?
What? That's not it at all.
You're probably planning on telling her about the horse witch, aren't you?
No. We're so dead.
What's wrong?
Max changed the schedule. Veronica's not doing dressage. She's jumping.
I don't think Nomad's ever seen a jump.
We have to stop her.
Okay, small vertical first and then the combo.
Hey, hold on. What horse are you riding?
Garnet. I just groomed her so well you didn't recognize her. Veronica, wait! Stop her! That's not Garnet. We didn't know she'd be jumping.
Veronica, wait!
Slow down! Whoa, Garnet, whoa!
Okay.
This isn't Garnet.
You just noticed that now. I don't believe this. What kind of stunt? What were you thinking?
It was a stupid thing to do.
We never meant to hurt anyone.
We didn't want Veronica to forget about Garnet.
I know what you were doing, but this was totally irresponsible and dangerous. You're suspended from Pine Hollow for 1 week.
Only a week? They tried to kill me.
If you learned to look after your own horse, Veronica, instead of handing her off at every opportunity, then maybe this wouldn't have happened.
But the light is on the mend. The inflammation's gone.
How did you get him to take it?
I used honey. I put the honey on my fingers and the tape. And then Samson, he licked my fingers. So then I put the bottle up and he licked the tape too. So I tipped up the bottle and in goes the milk. Easy.
This is a good start.
So you won't have to put the chute down his throat, will you?
If you keep feeding him, we won't have to.
Really?
Every 3 hours until Delilah's fully recovered. It could be a couple of days.
Every 3 hours? Even at night?
I'm afraid so.
It's okay, Melanie. If you show me how to do it, I'll take the night shift.
Hey, Comanche. I'm not allowed to see you for a whole week. I'm gonna miss you so much.
I'm sorry you got into trouble.
It was worth it. At least Max told Veronica to take care of Garnet.
I guess, but it's a drag you won't be able to ride.
Did you just come by to rub it in?
No, I just... I feel pretty bad about my parents' party this weekend. I didn't want you to come...
What?
I didn't want anyone to come from Pine Hollow.
Yeah, right, except Veronica.
No, my parents invited the D'Angelos. It's kind of embarrassing, but my mum put me in charge of the kids' pony rides. That's what Max's horse enclosures are for. It's a charity day to raise money. I have to wear a chic costume with a face bit cut out.
Really?
See, this is why I didn't tell you about the party in the first place.
I'm sorry, Phil.
Anyway, do you guys want to come to the party?
I don't know.
We'd love to.
Shouldn't you be gone by now? You're banned from the stables, you know.
We wanted to apologize first.
We didn't know you were gonna jump.
That was totally dangerous.
Please, I knew it wasn't Garnet. I just went along with it because Phil was there.
Uh-huh.
He's from our rival pony club. The honor of Pine Hollow was at stake.
Sure, Veronica.
See you guys on Saturday.
You're not inviting them, are you?
Yeah, they're helping out with the kids' pony rides.
The what?
Yeah, and we're going to dress up too. There's this great cow costume.
My mum said she needs someone to help out with the hot dogs.
Actually, I'm really sorry, Phil. I completely forgot. I'm busy on the weekend.
Oh.